A circular swimming pool has a diameter of 14 meters, the sides are 4 meters high, and the depth of the water is 3 meters. How much work in joules is required to pump all of the water over the side? The acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared, and the density of water is 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed. So for a quick review, in general, work is equal to force times distance. But if an object is moving along a straight line by a continuously varying force, f of x, then the work done by the force as the object is moved from x equals a to x equals b is given by the definite integral of f of x integrated with respect to x from a to b. To understand why this works, if we consider one increment of work, or in our case, the amount of work required to pump one disk of water over the top, it would be equal to the force times the distance increment. As we find more and more increments of work and then sum those increments, it would approach the total work, and therefore the work is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of the sum of delta w sub I from I equals 1 to n. And this limit gives us our definite integral. So to help us set up our integral, we'll focus on determining one increment of work, or the amount of work required to pump one disk over the top, and this will help us set up our definite integral. So going back to our example, let's label the given information. The circular swimming pool has a diameter of 14 meters, and therefore the radius would be equal to half this, or 7 meters. Next, the sides are 4 meters high, which is labeled here. The depth of the water is 3 meters, labeled here. If we consider this disk of water here, notice how the height or the thickness would be delta x, or more specifically, delta x sub I. If we let x be the distance from the bottom, then we could label this length here x sub I, and therefore notice how this disk must travel 4 minus x sub I meters over the top. Now again, our goal here is to find the increment of work required to pump this disk of water over the top, which we'll call delta W sub I, which is equal to the force times the distance. But before we find the force, we have to find the volume of this disk. And since this disk is a right circular cylinder, the volume is equal to pi r squared h, where r is 7, and the height h is equal to delta x sub I. Therefore, the volume is equal to 49 pi times delta x sub I. And now we know force is equal to mass times acceleration, but we don't know the mass of this disk of water. However, since the mass is equal to the density times the volume, and we know both of these, we can now find the mass. The density of the water is 1,000 kilograms per meter squared, the volume we just found, and the acceleration due to gravity, A, is 9.8 meters per second squared. So this product gives us the force of this disk of water, and now the disk of water must travel, again, 4 minus x sub I meters, and now we can find the increment of work required to pump this one disk of water over the top. Again, it's equal to force times distance. So delta W sub I is equal to the force of 1,000 times 49 pi delta x sub I times 9.8 times the distance, which is 4 minus x sub I. Remember, the work is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of the sum of these increments of work from I equals 1 to n. And therefore this product will give us our definite integral, where delta x sub I will be dx. So the actual work required to pump this water over the top is equal to the integral of 1,000 times, again, this delta x becomes dx, so we'll have 49 pi times 9.8 times 4 minus x times dx, And now for the limits of integration, notice how the distance is 4 minus x. So when x is 0, the distance would be 4, or 4 meters, which is the distance from the bottom of the pool. And we have 3 meters of water, so the upper limit of integration will be 3. Notice when x is 3, the distance is 1 meter, the distance the top water has to travel to the top of the pool. Let's go and evaluate this on the next slide. Notice how the product of these first three terms would just be a constant. Let's go ahead and factor that out. 1,000 times 49 times 9.8 is 480,200. We'll factor out the pi as well. Now we'll find the antiderivative of 4 minus x. That would be 4x minus x squared divided by 2. Notice when x is 3, we would have 12 minus, this would be 9 halves. And when x is 0, these are both 0. Well, 12 minus 9 halves would be 15 halves. Let's find the exact value on the calculator. So we'll leave pi in the product. 480,200 times 15 halves. Again, we still have pi in our product, so we have 3,601,500 pi. And the units would be kilograms times meters squared divided by seconds squared, which is joules. Let's also get our decimal approximation for this. So we'll multiply this by pi, giving us 11,314,445.94 joules. I hope you found this helpful.